At first I felt like, oh, it's just a drop of water in the ocean. And then somebody told me that, you know, all the little drops of water make up the ocean. So it makes me feel really good to be here. I'd be down there if I had money, and I have a teenage daughter and I couldn't leave her, but I'd go down there if I could and dig or do whatever, watch the kids.
We count all the boxes and then they have to be weighed. Well, and then we have to seal it. You know, we have to make sure it's packed tight. Some really nice first aid kits. See, all kinds of tapes, alcohol. These are real important to ship out. And you know, when you do something like this, you don't think about anything except helping, you know. Takes your mind off your own problems, your own situations. So that's good too.
This is hygiene and food products to go to Haiti. And what they're doing is palletizing it by commodity and getting it ready for shipping on Monday. Monday, a 40-foot sea container will show up, be dropped. We have a 2-hour load time, and we'll put 20 pallets onto that truck, 28,000 pounds. That truck will go right down to Miami and be flown right into Haiti. Now, this disaster has been especially a huge turnout just from community involvement, community volunteers. David Spontan is here today, 50 of them.
We've got teams all over the place. Mm-hmm. They've got some of them sorting dry food. They've got some of them sorting donations that are coming in. They've got some folks working on some medical supplies, a little bit of everything. When we got here, there wasn't any of this stuff going on. This is all the stuff that the students have done. They've boxed all these things up, palletized them, wrapped them up. Now they're just organizing. The only thing we're not doing is moving the pallets.